for a lot of us, we came up the hard way, right? And leadership is not an easy thing for social workers. We're not trained in leadership in school. And even if you are, when you're in your early 20s, it makes no sense, right? Until you're thrown in the deep end. And honestly, I've made a lot of mistakes, you know. I wish I could undo a lot of them, you know. But perhaps going through the years of experience, I try not to do it the way I did it. But these are some of the things that I've learned from being a leader. The first thing, of course, as I talked about, is integrity. I think very important. As a leader, you need to develop, or you need to have that integrity. Because if you don't have it, your staff are not going to have it. Because they're going to see through what you're doing. Right? The second thing is to have courage. You know, if you have the courage to do something and they see that you have that courage, they emulate you. And I think, you know, it's like somebody told me that, you know, a good student is when the student becomes better than the teacher. And I think that's what we all aim for, that every group of supervisees that we have becomes better than us. You know, we are not here to create a name for ourselves. You know, we are here to continue the legacy that we want to leave behind, right? I also think that, I know many people may not agree with me, but I also think that idealism is very important, that you have to be idealistic, right? You cannot be so pragmatic all the time. We are not Lee Kuan Yew, okay? We need to have a little bit, but Lee Kuan Yew also was very idealistic. He believed in the kind of society. He had a vision of what Singapore society should be, you know? And I think vision and idealism, I didn't put vision there, but I think vision and idealism is very important to have as a leader, okay? The concept of social justice, having that little bit of anger that you want to make a difference. Respect, okay, for your clients, for your colleagues, for your partners, okay. And I think most importantly, you must have a sense of humor. Okay, the kind of work that we do, if you don't have a sense of humor, it's a very sad day. We'll all end up in IMH with depression, and we'll be one of those statistics of the comorbidity of mental health in Singapore. 1:6. 1:6, right? So we'll be one of their statistics. So I think having that sense of humor is very important. It gets us by.